FSC, Fest Jack Speed and Custom Shop. Today we're going to continue on my son's 1974 Ford F-100 stereo install. Now, a while back, we did start filming removing of the dash, taking the doors apart, pulling the speakers out, and relocating the holes. I did, however, just start working on the subwoofer installation, and that kind of took on a life of its own because the speaker has to be raised up above, and we'll go ahead and show you why. It can't be floor mounted, it's got to be raised up a little bit. Little seatbelt clearance issue. That's important. Got to deal with it. Custom life, right? So with that being said, we're going to get ahead and jump right into this video real quick without a whole heck of a lot of me BSing. Let's go. The next step, I believe, is just to get the seat out. There's going to be a subwoofer in the back behind there. He's got just this old seat cover on there. Probably like an old saddleman or something from back in the day. The seat pulls forward like so, and you can see why. An old CB wire from the CB that used to be in here. Obviously, you need to vacuum this up somewhat. I'm going to go ahead and pull these seat belts out right here. Now, Jen, pardon the dust in front of the lens. I got the light on. Now, Jen, you know when people say you haven't cleaned your truck in 20 years or maybe 30 years? You know how you could date it?
Ah, I see.
You see it?
Yup.
For those wondering what I'm talking about, when is the last time you've seen one of these? And that was on the floor of this truck. It is a 74 after all.
It's probably from 74.
Who knows? Yeah, it's time to vacuum out your truck.
It doesn't look that bad for being this old.
Yeah, but here, that's under the seat. You can see where Sean had, like, cleaned it, you know, and vacuumed it and whatnot where he could reach. But my point is, you literally have an artifact from 30 years ago laying in the back there. I mean, I remember Budweiser cans having those when I was a child. I'm 41. I was born in 77. So just to date, it might be an older video by the time people are watching it. I'm born in 77. I remember those pull tabs when I was a kid, like 8, 9 maybe or so like that, when I was still young enough to run to the fridge and get my dad a beer. I haven't seen one of these in many, many years. That's funny. That's almost an artifact right there. Mm-hmm. What else you find in there?
An old film wrapper paper for Kodak, I'm pretty sure. But it's won't make them anymore, I don't think. Or nobody uses them anymore.
I'm doing it one-handed, baby. No. Yeah, it is. It's an old Kodak. Look right there. Old Kodak.
Mm-hmm.
That's an artifact right there. Clean your truck, you find artifacts. God knows what this used to be. Jen found that yellow thing, thought it was a condom wrapper. That looks like a modern receipt. Check the date though.
Yeah, 9/23/2017.
All right, this is obviously Sean. 9/23/17. What did Sean buy? Sausage Egg McMuffin. No, this might be me. 2 Sausage McMuffin. No, that's not Sean. That's me all day. Where is this? Berkeley, South Carolina. That might be the day I left when I drove the truck back to Wisconsin. For those that don't remember, I drove this truck all the way in from South Carolina here with the blown engine in it. It wasn't blown. It was just basically seven cylinders. But I drove her all the way in from South Carolina.
I think that's kind of it.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to start vacuuming. Basically, when we went to the store, I went with my son, and he just whipped out his card and bought, like, the entire stereo system all at once. Now, we've already opened up the head unit and the two door speakers to mess with that, but for right now, what I'm doing is I already took the seat out of the truck, as you just saw, and I have to put this bass box in there. The problem is the bass box we need to put in the middle, but we have to raise it up a little bit because otherwise it won't lay flat on the floor, and the seat belts are right there. So once we get the wiring set, we've got to put the rug back down, put the seat belts back down before the seat goes in, obviously, and then elevate the bass box. So let's just go ahead and unbox this right here and show what we've got. It's a very basic box. One speaker set up for the depth of the truck back seat. We were thinking about putting two, decided to be a little bit much. I would have put two. 12-inch kicker subwoofer. Watt amplifier. Very conveniently placed sticker right over it, which will stand vertically, something like that. And a wiring kit. Got that. Right here with the subwoofer enclosure is this. I took these out. They used to be right here where the
plugs, you know, where you plug your wires to it.
These right here, these little spring little deals, you put your wire in, you know, and you squish them. Squish them like so, shove your wire in, and closes.
Here's what I don't like about them. This here, these little plugs attached to that nut, neither one were tight, by the way. And that plug right there, this little silver piece, attaches there with a spade connector. And then I guess they assume the speaker attaches with spade connectors as well. Now, the speaker right here doesn't have those spade connectors. My point is this. If we eliminate this little pigtail from inside here, which isn't able to be gotten to unless you unbolt the speaker from the box itself right here, let's just eliminate it and run a speaker wire directly through the holes right to the speaker. The amp is going to be right next to it right about here. So it's not like you have to be able to disconnect it easy. Even if you do, you're only going to have a couple feet of wire hanging out of the speaker box for this particular installation. So we're going to delete these. Food for thought. I'm not saying that's what you should do. That's just what I'm going to do. Now the subwoofer install is complete. All I have to do is put the seat back as far as this goes. But she's already wired in. All I have left to do here is hook up the power to the positive battery terminal, but I'm not going to do that yet. It's got a 60 amp fuse by kicker. I went and wrapped it all up underneath it. Snakes along down by the starter wire, which is this red wire. Splits off from the starter wire. Comes down. I insulated it with a hose to go down the length of the frame. And on up into the body of the truck. The ground
is the gray one, comes down. I ground the frame bare, hooked it up, and then repainted it quick. Just trying to keep the rust off that bare piece. Now that's grounded right to the main frame rail. Now the body is grounded with this wire here from the engine right here up to the body. I went and ran another ground. Right there you see the paint mark. Up into the battery's negative terminal. And that's how I wired it.
Thank you for watching. Well, that concludes the subwoofer installation in the truck. Hope you liked it. Hope you see exactly how I did it. Why you have to kind of use your head to be able to custom mount these things. It's easy just to slap it together. But if you want to put it together, make it look really nice, wire it properly, you got to spend some time. Next up, I got to put the head unit in the truck. I've got to get the dashboard wiring all set up, put the seat back in, put the speakers in the door, put the door upholstery back on the doors, put the glass back all in the doors. The next video is going to be finishing the stereo system over here. So how about this? Why don't you guys go ahead and join the FSC crew? Hit that subscribe button, grab that notification bell. That way you'll know it the instant it drops. With that being said, I am Steve Feshtek. This is FSC, Feshtek Speed and Custom Shop. What else can I build for you?